8:45 and welcome back. We have stress in our lives, and we all want to find ways to get rid of it. And one good place to start is actually with what we eat. Some foods add to our stress, and some foods can actually take our stress away. True. Joining us now is an expert on that, Dr. Ben Beckler. And we're going to start with the bad stuff first. We'll get that out of the way.
Absolutely. Well, we know that stress in our bodies has a multitude of impacts, short-term, long-term. Short-term, we think about our ability to concentrate. We think about sleep, impacts our relationships and overall fatigue in our bodies and our lives. Long-term, it causes us to gain weight. We think about heart impact.
Organs
and major immune suppression. Brain. And leads to sickness, illness, catching of the common cold. There are certain foods we want to avoid and other ones we want to incorporate into our diets. We've got some of those to avoid. Of course, I mean, it's obvious, but when we think about the mechanism, these foods lead to increase in blood sugar spikes, mm-hmm. increase in cortisol.
All stuff we love, of course.
Right, exactly. That stress production hormone, cortisol, that gets out there in the body, suppresses the immune system. We can lift some of this up here. You know, a recent study went and looked at different diets. We find higher protein, lower carbs, most beneficial when we think about weight, lipids, cholesterol. We think about blood pressure. Here, we really refer to these as glue foods in our clinic. And you think about the idea and the concept that specifically these cause the blood sugar to go up, spike, get that crash and burn type of attitude, and really relates to the concept and idea of our body really getting out of balance. So that moves us really saying, well, what should we eat or what are the things we want to increase in the diet?
The healthy stuff. Okay.
The healthy stuff, right.
And this is stuff we've talked about year after year on this show, and most people know that a lot of fruits and vegetables. Colorful food, that's a key if you need to have some kind of a guideline.
You know, research supports broad spectrum ingestion of a multitude of different types of food, not just a single isolated nutrient or food. So number one, go for variety. What do we want to shoot for? We want antioxidants, number one. Number two, we think about omega-3 essential fatty acids. So much research promotes mood, promotes brain function, good for the heart and lipids. We want to focus on magnesium and potassium. Potassium for blood pressure. Where can we find it? Well, potassium and bananas. And also celery sticks, believe it or not. When we think about our omegas, we think about nuts, we think about salmon. Magnesium in integrative circles, really known as the calming mineral.
And red meat in moderation.
But red meat in moderation. We always want to go with the low fat, moderate portion size. That's definitely generous size here. One serving, we think about 4 ounces. Now, one thing you may not know. The government recently increased the number of fruits and vegetables. We always hear about the 5 a day. It's now gone to 10. U.S. Health and Human Services, Healthy People 2010.
That's hard to do.
10 servings.
I eat a lot of fruits and vegetables, and it is hard to do 10, but that's good. That's a good guideline.
Well, and because of
start
the guidelines and the idea that most of us, I know myself, even as much as I try, I don't eat perfectly, and I know the folks that I know certainly don't. And so that's why we start looking to fill in those nutritional gaps
with supplements. That's what we're going over here.
They're not a replacement for eating a healthy diet or exercising or quitting smoking or getting regular health checkups, but they can be part of a healthy
variety.
Lifestyle. Absolutely.
And a lot of these are in liquid form and not in pill form.
Absolutely. We think about enhanced absorption in liquid form. We also think about the pharmacokinetics of certain, for example, soft gels. So know your supplement company. Know the background information. These are Eniva products here. I'm a chief scientific officer there. So we spend a lot of time focusing on the pharmacokinetics and studies behind the products. Think about what you're cooking
with.
Because
we don't want to, I mean, we've heard this before, that you take vitamin supplements and that you pee them out. And nobody wants to spend money on vitamins that you pee out.
Absolutely. And that has to do with the design and the pharmacokinetics, really the research and development behind the products. In fact, funny you say that. A study came out showing that 68% of the tablets and pills, multinutrient standard supplements on the market, don't meet the dissolution standard. They don't go to work in the body.
Does that mean they're staying in our stomach?
Well, we either pass them out the back door or they go out the front door. Enough said, right? Things to focus on for stress, antioxidant, broad spectrum, don't mega dose. So that's number one when you're picking out a supplement. Two, preferable liquid form. Omegas, EPA and DHA, docosahexaenoic acid and icosapentaenoic acid. Big words, EPA,
okay.
DHA, 1,000 milligrams.
Eat a lot of fruits and vegetables and, you know, do it in all moderation.
Absolutely. So, B-complex, vitamin C, and again, incorporate supplements as part of a healthy lifestyle, regular exercise, regular checkups. Make good choices, and don't drink alcohol before going to sleep. It disrupts the sleep cycle. Doesn't help you sleep.
You're not getting enough sleep. Don't drink alcohol before.
Right.
Thank you, Dr. Ben.
You're welcome.
Dr. Ben Beckler. Okay.